As in, like, third strike character face buttons.
Yeah,
made my day. It's red, too.
Yeah,
oh,
I know.
Man.
I was about to say, yeah.
Dude, so perfect.
So I got a Dudley, but my Dudley wasn't blue. I was so jealous that I bought a blue button just so I can swap it out. Because I was like, damn it, David got his red Q. I need a blue Dudley.
Do you play blue Dudley? Is there... Honestly, I don't know what color
there's not
really.
Well, blue Dudley, the closest is like kind of default color, right?
I honestly have no idea what his colors are.
I mean, one of my favorite ones was pink Dudley, but I can't play it because that's Coco Jean's color.
Only one person gets pink Dudley.
Exactly. Shout outs to Xanthan.
Yeah, that's a good game.
Yeah, and shout outs to Xanthan as well. I know he's really into the fighting game community. I see him all the time on Twitter and such. So,
if you're interested in this game, you can buy a slightly janky version of it on the PlayStation 3. You can get the PS2 version like ported over to PS3.
No online. And if you want to learn everything about the game, including that's where I found the health data, it's in my own CVS2 fact on GameFAQs.com. Pretty much almost all information you need about the game is there.
EG Justin Wong on the left, Mike Watson on the right. Justin Wong was one of the best in this game in the U.S. He made top eights at Evo a bunch.
Mm-hmm.
His Vega, so solid.
Yeah, I mean, he plays a super defensive Vega, and when we saw from Watson yesterday, a very much more offensive Vega. But the interesting thing about it might be just matchup dependent, because right now Justin is not turtling as much.
Yeah, Justin's in zombie Vega on the left.
Yeah.
Keeping it pretty close. Mike Watson just has such good fundamentals in everything.
Yeah.
So does Justin. Nice. Trying to build meter, smart man. Ooh, from the front.
Just got him. Yeah, the nice thing about playing with a lot of fundamentals is that you don't have to remember all the game-specific stuff.
Yeah.
If you just understand how fighting games work and how human psychology works, you can usually make up for it. Justin, I know, hasn't played this game in a long time.
Yeah. Vega's a pretty obvious character how to play.
Yeah.
Not too tricky.
Watson trying to go with some Chun-Li here. Oh, no. And yeah, that is Vega's best combo. He jumps so fast, it's really hard to charge up for a roll in time. So jump roundhouse, stand roundhouse, and the flip is what you usually see people do as their most damaging Justin jump-in combo.
Yeah, you're not really playing Vega for the damage for the most part. Mm-hmm. Just for control. And you can see the control.
Mm-hmm. Watson having a really hard time trying to get in.
Justin was waiting for it.
I mean, that's pretty much super old school CVS2 strategy is roll to get in.
Oh, yeah. like year one strats.
Yeah. Not going to work, unfortunately, for Watson against a player like Justin.
Okay.
Oh, okay. That time it did.
Oh, I thought that was going to be RC legs.
Did he do wake up, roll, cancel?
I did wake up, roll, cancel. Yeah. Huh?
That's pretty impressive because, I mean, honestly, Justin's not a roll, cancel guy.
Well, maybe he didn't. I don't know that there was actually a media attack, but that might have been what he wanted.
Right.
Yeah, Justin typically doesn't do that stuff. I think he did do it in this game, but, for example, in third strike, he doesn't care a throw.
Right. I mean, he's learned it. He had to learn it to fight a lot of guys like Nestor in East Coast was super good at this game, and he beat Justin at a tournament using a lot of roll cancels, which kind of spurred him to learn it.
Nice timing on the DP. Finally gets through Vega.
It's kind of really similar to how Watson doesn't really use parries too often in third strike.
Right. So they have the same teams? I guess I didn't realize before, but they got the same teams. It's a mirror match.
Yeah, I mean, these are all very strong fundamental characters, good footsie characters.
Yeah.
Especially Chun-Li with that stand strong, such a good button. Ridiculously good button, can be canceled in the fireball. Remember, she's not a charge character outside of bird kick.
Ooh, that was a chance. Yeah, she has good confirms, good buttons, good mobility, good pressure.
And Watson just doing so much damage with that low fierce.
Yeah, if he can take it back with Sagat, if he gets a kill quickly, it's not going to be even exactly. Oh, okay. Whoa,
too far.
That is really unfortunate.
Wow.
So Mike. Mike, you know, he's down in life right now, but he has more meter.
Yep.
He can be a danger.
Justin was like, that wouldn't have happened in third strike.
Look at that guard bar already.
Yep.
Mike Watson's guard.
That guard bar is the green right under the life. Oh,
just
damage.
Got it.
Yeah, that I think low fierce in the level one super combos at every range. Oh, and he gets a stun.
Oh, that was about as destruction as it could have been. Sagat. It's awesome to me that Mike Watson did so well at the tournaments. You know, he obviously he's the one who organized this thing.
Yeah,
we're all here because he put this tournament together in honor of Evo 2004 with a bunch of the games that were at Evo 2004 when he was. I don't know if that was his competitive peak, but he was still really good at the time.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
He was still a major threat in a bunch of games at the time. And you can see it. He just has awesome fundamentals. Yeah, he was one of the best of all time.
I think he was in top eight. I think he was in top eight in Third Strike that year.
Oh, was it that year? I mean, I know it happened.
Because I remember he was top eight in one of the games because he definitely had one of the player introductions where he got to walk down.
Okay. This huge hallway here, right?
Yeah, I know. This ballroom in that year was so large, and now it's like, interesting trade on the alpha counter.
Great pressure from Justin.
All right. Oh, wow. Just decides to keep the pressure going with that.
Oh, look at Mike Watson's guard. He can't take anything.
Yeah. Gets the throw. I mean, Vega really can't do much else, but he'll take it. That's free damage.
Yeah.
Free damage is free damage. So. Yeah. And not only that, but the free damage is great because that's actually it might be an interesting strategy. If you're about to be guard broken by Vega and he doesn't have any meter, maybe you should just let it happen. Because if you play scared, then that's how the opponent can predict you a little bit earlier, right? And unlike Alpha 3, the guard bar doesn't get shorter every time you get guard broken. But again, Chun-Li really... Oh, he's got to stop that roll. Justin is ready for it every time. Chun-Li has an okay roll. Not one of the greatest, though.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nice block. Pretty ambiguous. Justin building a little bit of meter over there. You build meter by whiffing buttons in this game. Rolled, not punished, but didn't really get anything going for him either. You see his... No, oh, I thought he was going to die. Next hit's going to do it, of course.
Yeah, just trying to get any extra damage, and it's working right now.
Well, nice block again.
Oh, you see that? He did stand strong into Fireball. Vega still jumped over it and punished. You have to be really careful. Vega jumps so fast in this game.
Down to Sagat again. With Sagat, you know, he made it past a couple of characters, ended up getting dunked by Justin's. He's got the meter to be a big threat. And of course, with that ratio too, he's dealing more damage versus ratio 1 Vega than he would if he was 1. Oh, no.
Oh, he got him. Wow.
Kind of surprised.
I guess Justin hit a button or something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, Justin had been doing a lot of meaty low short in the roll.
Sure.
So.
Justin's Chun. Good bet he's not going to go for level 3 super.
Oh, but here he goes going with that. You don't know which one he's doing. It's either going to be 2, 4, or 6 hits.
Ooh, no super. He just built 2.
Yeah. I think he tried it, but just didn't come out.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
No.
Wake up low short from Watson. Knew that because he uppercutted him last time. So he knew Justin wasn't going to go for any meaties. That Tor's forward kick, a pretty nice button against Sagat.
Oh, here it is.
Oh.
No.
Yeah, Justin doesn't really go for that combo that much because I think he's always worried about missing the link.
Well, if he gets another hit, another touch even, he might go for super. No, and no, I guess not anymore. No,
nice
he's going to get away, though.
Yeah.
Oh, Justin might have tried for autocorrect super. And Chun's doing her job. Just whittle down Sagat as much as possible. Obviously, it'd be great if he beat Mike outright, but even if not, just take away as much life as possible.
Yeah,
this is still great for Justin.
Oh, yeah. Fantastic. Yeah, Chun-Li has average roll length.
Got it.
27 frames.
I don't know about this position for Mike.
Well, this is going to be a tough comeback.
Oh, is that a punish?
I'm not sure, but the thing about it was, I mean, Mike didn't even have an advantage on the meter.
Yeah, he was in a bad spot.
I mean, that's the crazy thing. I mean, I talked about this yesterday, how this is a very meter-dependent game. Like, you really need to try to land your super combos on your opponent, and that's kind of, because you notice normal combos don't do a lot of damage.